Hello, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I shall share a formula to spell a cumulative range with functions subtotal, offset, and sequence. On the screen, in my Excel sample worksheet non-schedule report, which was introduced in my previous video, I have the non-input and date dynamic array list across columns C, D, and E. Based on these inputs, I can use Excel PPMT to spell out the principal payment list in column G. The array formula could be equal to minus PPMT open bracket read should be month read, i.e. D6 divided by 12. Period should be in column C, C11 hash mark. Number of period should be D7 times 12. Present value should be the number in cell D5. Skip or leave the list argument as empty. Choose a bracket, enter. We get a dynamic list for principal payment for each period under column G. Now we need to calculate the dynamic range list in column H for accumulating the principal payment in terms of each payment period in column C. My suggested array formula could be in column H11 equal to subtotal open bracket. We get blue link first argument is function number. Click the link. The pop-up window lists all numbers for different functions. We want some or no number which included hidden rows. That should be 9. The reference range is listed in column G. As it is a dynamic range, we should apply offset function to present it. Type offset function in. Reference should be the dynamic range G11 hash mark. Row is 0, column is 0, height is a dynamic row number of range G11 hash mark, which we can use the function sequence and rows to generate, which should be the sequence open bracket rows function open bracket G11 hash mark, close with all corresponding brackets. We get the expected calculated accumulated value, principal payments. This formula is working well and only depends on the dynamic range in column G. In our case, as we have already the previous calculated period number in column C, that can be presented as the heights of the range in column G. Thus, you can also replace the sequence parts by C11 hash mark. We get the same list result. But for this demo, let's put back the formula. By using same way, we can spell the list in column I and J for interest payment, and it is a cumulative payment with function IPMT. For month payment, we combine the two arrays under principal payment and interest in the payment, i.e. the G11 hash mark plus I11 hash mark. For loan remaining balance, we just use the loan amount in D5 minus the array range cumulative principal payment H11 hash mark. For loan start balance, we use the loan remaining balance L11 hash mark plus the principal payment G11 hash mark. By now you can see that by using only Excel array functions, we can achieve a dynamic long schedule report without any VBA code nice. Okay, let's change the long inputs for some tests. That is all about in this video. From this video, in an example of a non-scheduled report sheet, you know how to calculate the cumulative values for a dynamic range by using subtotal, offset, and sequences functions. Corresponding, we can easily calculate the list, balance lists, and finally, we get a dynamic non-scheduled report by Excel array functions only without any supports from VBA macro codes. Thanks for your watching. If you like to watch more videos from my channel, please press subscribe button. See you in next video.